Hi everyone and welcome back to Stern Effects. My name is Eran and I'm using After Effects for more than 30 years. Over this time I found out that there are some settings you should change in After Effects to get the most out of it. Do you want to see them? Sure you do! Also make sure to stick until the end for a bonus tip. Alright, let's go! First up, let's get rid of this pesky home screen that pops up every time you open After Effects. So just go to the settings, which will be the preferences on the Windows side, and then under Setup and Repair, uncheck Enable Home Screen. Click OK and then switch to another workspace and back to what you were using. And the home screen icon will disappear and never comes back to haunt you again. Next time you launch the app, you'll be taken straight to your workspace, saving you precious time. Next, let's turn off those coach marks, which most of the time just get in the way. So if you're like me, tired of those pop-ups giving you tips and tricks, go back to the preferences under the general section this time, uncheck enable coach marks. This will make your interface cleaner and less distracting. To make working with paths and mask handles easier, go to the preferences, then general, and increase the path point and handle size to about 8 pixels. You can go as high as 15 if you like. This makes those tiny points more visible and easy to select, which is super handy and help you to fine-tune your masks and shapes. Tired of manually centering the anchor point in shape layers? Head on to the preferences, then general, and check center anchor point in new shape layers. Now, every time you create a shape, the anchor point will be smack dab in the center automatically. If your preview isn't playing back in real time, the audio can get really annoying and scary. To remedy this, go to the preferences, then preview, and check mute audio when preview is not real time. This will save your ears from unnecessary stress. To see all the keyframes in a motion path, not just those in a 15 seconds range, go to the preferences, then display, and check all keyframes under the motion path option. This gives you a full overview of your animation, because remember, you are the boss. For a quick rule of thirds guide, change your proportional grid under the grid and guide section to 3x3. Then click OK, and when you'll select the proportional grid from this pop-up menu, you'll be able to align elements perfectly according to the rule of thirds. Your comps already looks so much better. To clean up your font selection process, go to Preferences, then Type, and set Preview size to medium, for my tired eyes at least, and also limit the number of recent fonts to display to 8. I think it's enough. This makes choosing fonts much faster and less overwhelming. If you use scripts frequently, this is a must. Go to the preferences, then scripting and expressions, and check allow scripts to write files and access network. Also, uncheck warn user when executing files. This will streamline your workflow, especially when working with third-party scripts. When working in 3D, changing the camera pointer to a directional indicator can be a game changer. To do it, go to the preferences, then 3D, and select directional indicator for the camera manipulation point. This gives you a better control and visual feedback when navigating in 3D space. Oh, finally, we can see the orientation angle. good stuff. And here is a bonus tip. Let's clean up that workspace menu. Click on the overflow menu and select Edit Workspaces. Here, you can hide the workspaces you don't use by dragging them to the overflow menu. This keeps your interface tidy and helps you focus on the tools that you need. Remember that you can also double-click on a workspace name to reset it to the last saved version. This is great when you switch screens or change your monitor resolution. And there you have it, 10 plus 1 settings that will make your After Effects experience smoother and more efficient. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and click the bell icon to stay updated with more tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next one.